If you are currently taking insulin medication, you're gonna wanna watch this video. Insulin could be making your insulin resistance and diabetes worse. Here's everything you need to know and what you can do about it. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name's Kate. I'm a certified health and nutrition coach. I post videos twice a week here on YouTube talking all things insulin resistance, weight loss, sleep, and more. So if you're ready to take control of your metabolic health, make sure to click that subscribe button. And you can also find me on TikTok and Instagram where I share new posts every single day. Both type 1 and type 2 diabetes are characterized by the body not being able to manage blood sugar efficiently. But the reason behind why this is happening could not be more opposite. Let's start off by talking about the difference between type 1 and type 2 diabetes, and then we will get into why insulin might actually be progressing the disease, or in some cases, even contributing to double diabetes. So we're gonna start off with type 2 because that is the most common. Almost 90% of diabetes cases are type 2. As mentioned at the start of this video, type 2 diabetes means that your body is not managing blood glucose correctly. And this leads to higher than normal blood sugar levels. Now, the thing about type 2 diabetes is that it's a lifestyle disease, and it develops after years of being insulin resistant. Insulin is the hormone responsible for keeping our blood sugar in check. When our blood sugar levels rise, insulin is released and it shuttles the excess sugar from our bloodstream to our cells. However, our cells can sometimes start to resist the actions of insulin, not taking in blood sugar as they should. And this is known as insulin resistance. We end up getting into this cycle where blood sugar is always rising, mainly as a result of diet, and then insulin is constantly being pumped out to deal with it. But as the resistance progresses, blood sugar remains high for longer than it should, so the body pumps out even more insulin to deal with it. And for a while, this excess insulin is enough to keep blood sugar in check and within a healthy range when we measure it. And this is why insulin resistance goes undiagnosed for so long. Doctors are not routinely testing insulin. But eventually, the excess insulin is not able to keep up, and this is when you start to see your fasting blood sugar rise. At this point, you're going to be diagnosed with prediabetes, or if it's progressed even further, type 2 diabetes. So in summary, type 2 diabetes is a result of too much insulin overwhelming our cells. And now let's get into type 1 diabetes. Remember how I said earlier that type 1 diabetes and type 2 diabetes couldn't be more opposite? Here's what I meant by that. Whereas type 2 diabetes is caused by too much insulin, type 1 diabetes is caused by not enough insulin. Type 1 diabetes is an autoimmune condition where the body is not able to produce adequate insulin. And because it is only able to produce a very small amount of insulin, if any at all, there is nothing to take the excess sugar from the bloodstream to your cells. This results in blood sugar rising and not being able to come back down. So whereas type 2 diabetes can be reversed with some diet and lifestyle changes, type 1 diabetes, unfortunately, doesn't have a cure. It can really only be managed. So now let's get into how type 1 diabetes and type 2 diabetes are treated. Oftentimes, they're treated the same way, with the patient being prescribed insulin. And for type 1 diabetics, this makes sense. The body is not able to produce insulin, a hormone which all of us need, so injecting it, like I said, makes sense. Without insulin, blood sugar can become dangerously high, which can result in many irreversible side effects, one of which being death. So insulin injections are absolutely necessary for someone who has type 1 diabetes. But where insulin injections don't make sense is with type 2 diabetes. Because remember, this is a disease that is actually caused by too much insulin. So by adding more insulin, yes, this can temporarily bring blood sugar down, but in the long run, it's only gonna make the insulin resistance worse. And eventually the dose of insulin is going to have to be increased. And this is why type 2 diabetes is often referred to as a progressive disease. Because by injecting insulin, the problem only gets worse and worse. But the truth is that type 2 diabetes is not a progressive disease. It can be reversed. And you do this by addressing the root cause, insulin resistance. Now, another common treatment for type 2 diabetes is the prescription drug metformin. Metformin's really interesting because it's a drug that improves insulin sensitivity. A lot of type 2 diabetics do find they have good results on this drug and an easier time managing their blood sugar. However, metformin does come with a long list of side effects, and these side effects are not often mentioned when the drug is prescribed. Severe digestive distress, hair loss, severe fatigue. For men, it can lead to low testosterone. It depletes key nutrients in the body, including vitamin B12. So it's not entirely a miracle drug. Yes, it's effective, but the side effects sometimes are not pretty. I do have a full video talking about the side effects and how you can avoid some of them, so I will link that up above if you want to know more. But the point that I'm trying to make here is that metformin improves insulin sensitivity, and that is why it is so effective for type 2 diabetes, because it is essentially helping to address the root cause. Now, if there was a way to improve insulin sensitivity without a drug, wouldn't you want that to be your first option? Now, before I go any further, I want to make one thing very clear. Do not by any means make any changes to your diet or to your medication without consulting with your doctor first. And the reason that this is so important, because the diet changes I am about to outline are so extremely effective that they reduce your need for insulin rapidly. If you change your diet and you don't adjust your dose, no matter if you're type 1 or type 2 diabetic, this can result in you experiencing low blood sugar or hypoglycemia, which can be just as dangerous as high blood sugar. But anyways, what I'm getting at is that low carb diets are an extremely effective strategy for improving insulin sensitivity, reversing insulin resistance, for reversing type 2 diabetes, and for managing type 1 diabetes. Let's talk about how it helps type 1 first. So, as I mentioned before, type 1 diabetes doesn't have a cure, it's an autoimmune condition. The body is simply not making enough insulin, which is something we need, so it has to be injected. But what a type 1 diabetic can do is reduce how much insulin they need. And you can do this by reducing carbohydrates in the diet. Because when we eat foods that contain carbs, these carbs are broken down into glucose, aka sugar, and they enter our bloodstream, causing our blood sugar to rise. The same does not happen when we eat protein and fat. So by eating fewer carbs, less insulin is needed, and it can be easier to manage type 1 diabetes. Now, type 1 diabetics will know that diet is not the only thing that impacts our blood sugar, but it is one of the easiest to control. And there is a lot of evidence supporting them. A 2019 study had type 1 diabetics eating less than 100 grams of carbohydrates a day for 12 weeks. After that, they ate over 250 carbs a day for another 12 weeks. During the low carb phase, they had more stable blood sugar levels and had fewer episodes of low blood sugar versus the high carb phase. Not to mention that they lost an average of 5 pounds. And there is also a lot of evidence supporting the effectiveness of low carb diets for type 2 diabetes. On one study done on 28 type 2 diabetics, after 16 weeks, 7 were able to discontinue their diabetes medication entirely, and another 10 were able to reduce it. The study concluded, because the low-carb ketogenic diet can be very effective at lowering blood glucose, patients on diabetes medication who use this diet should be under close medical supervision or capable of adjusting their medication. And this is what I mentioned before. Low-carbohydrate ketogenic diets will reduce your need for insulin rapidly. They are going to help you to reverse insulin resistance and reverse type 2 diabetes. And as I mentioned earlier, they can also help to manage type 1 diabetes. Now, if you're not sure how to start making these diet and lifestyle changes, I do have a coaching program aimed at improving insulin resistance, which I will link above. This 7-day masterclass gives you everything you need to get started. It has shopping lists, it has a sample 7-day meal plan, and you get to work with me so I can provide you some more guidance and support. And if you're a bit hesitant, I encourage you to at least give it a try. It might seem overwhelming at first, but I promise you, low-carb diets are extremely sustainable. They can be surprisingly enjoyable and easy to maintain. And once you start getting results, you're gonna be sold. Anyways, guys, that's all I have for you today. Let me know in the comment section down below if you are currently prescribed insulin and what your experience has been. Have you had to increase your dose as time goes on? Have you made any diet or lifestyle changes and have these helped? Let me know down below. I love chatting with you guys in the comment section. If you did enjoy this video, you might also enjoy my video on how to lower your HbA1c. You can check that out here. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, you can find that here. And if you want to check out my coaching programs, including my 7-day insulin resistance masterclass, you can find that here. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.